one is the English translation.
Number one, English translation.
What canals?
Channel?
One. One English.
One English?
Two Bulgarian.
One is English?
Добър ден на всички. Добре дошли на нашата пресконференция след неформалната среща на министрите на енергетиката. Тук са българския министр на енергетиката Теменужка Петкова и еврокомисарът по климатичното действие и енергетиката Мигел Ариас Канети, които ще ви запознаят с днешната работа на министрите. Госпожо министър, имате думата.
Благодаря ви. Уважаеми господин комисар, уважаеми дами и господа, днес беше проведена неформална среща на министрите по енергетика в рамките на Европейския съюз, в рамките на българското председателство. Смея да твърдя, че днешната среща премина изключително добре. Обект на дискусии бяха три много важни досиета от законодателния пакет «Чиста енергия за всички европейци», досиета, по които предстоят преговори с Европейския парламент. Дискусията премина изключително ползотворно, беше изключително градивна. Получихме визия, получихме яснота по отношение на позициите на държавите членки, по отношение на три много важни досиета. Това е регламентът за управление, това е директивата за енергийна ефективност и директивата за възобновяеми енергийни източници. Наред с това бяха обсъдени съществени елементи, свързани с изменение на регламента за създаване на Агенция за сътрудничество между регулаторите на енергия в рамките на Европейския съюз. Всички знаем колко важен и фундаментален за енергийното развитие на Европа е законодателния пакет «Чиста енергия за всички европейци». Всички знаем колко важен е прехода към нисковъглеродна икономика. Именно законодателния пакет «Чиста енергия за всички европейци», който всички се обединяваме около това, че може да бъде определен като изключително амбициозен и уникален по своята същност, дава отговори, дава насоки по отношение на това как да бъде извършен този преход към нисковъглеродна икономика, чрез какви мерки. Тези мерки са свързани именно с енергийната ефективност, с енергията от възобновяеми енергийни източници. Мерки, които гарантират устойчивост, мерки, които гарантират растеж. Изключително много благодаря на колегите министри, изключително много благодаря за дискусията, която се получи. Българското председателство ще използва всички тези мнения, всички тези гледни точки, които бяха споделени, за да формира своята позиция по отношение на предстоящите преговори с Европейския парламент. Ние сме си поставили амбициозната цел в рамките на българското председателство да приключим тези три изключително важни досиета от пакета «Чиста енергия за всички европейци». Наред с това сме си поставили и друга амбициозна цел, а именно да постигнем общ подход по отношение на досието, свързано с дейността на регулаторите на енергия в рамките на Европейския съюз. Благодаря много още веднъж за изключително добрата дискусия, за подкрепата, която получи българското председателство и на комисията, и на моите колеги министри. Благодаря ви.
Благодаря ви, госпожо министър. Господин комисар, имате думата.
Dear Minister, dear members of the press, thank you for coming to this press conference. And let me start by thanking Minister Petkova for the invitation to come to this great city of Sofia. And thank her and her team for a very well-organized energy minister informal meeting and this afternoon high-level conference on the Balkan perspective for Europe low-carbon future. As you will be aware, the main issues we have discussed are related to the clean energy for all European packages. Early this week, the European Parliament adopted the final test on the energy performance in the Buildings Directive, with an impressive political support, and we hope that the Council will do the same thing this next month. The Bulgarian presidency is working on three extremely important elements of the clean energy package. One of them fundamental for the success of the package, which is the governance. The second is the energy efficiency regulation and the recast of the renewables directive. In all those three items, the Bulgarian presidency has conducted technical and political negotiations, but today we have to test where was the situation with the different ministers. And the message that we have given from the Commission is that we have to have ambition, that this is the moment to raise the ambition of our targets. We established a targets in the past, in the October 2014 Council, which were established according to the costs of the technologies at that time. But what we have seen since 2014 is that the cost of renewable energy has dramatically been reduced, whether it is wind power onshore and offshore, whether it's solar panels, or whether it's in order to steer the cost of batteries. And now we can achieve, with the same level of cost efficiency, more ambitious targets. And there has been an exchange of views. There have been delegations who are willing to have targets more ambitious, even not so high as the ones that the Parliament has put on the table. Other delegations have been more prudent, and the role of the Bulgarian presidency will be to find that compromise amongst the Parliament and the Council position that will be require lots of work, but I am confident that along the Bulgarian presidency we will get it. And the Commission will act as an honest broker to reach that agreement. We also have discussed the role of the ACER, of the agency who coordinates the national regulators, and whether it should maintain these competences, whether we should have new competences, whether the role of the director should be preserved. And also here there has been a good spirit of cooperation. There have been member states who have presented working documents, and we also are sure that the Bulgarian presidency will be able to have a general approach agreed on ACER before the end of the presidency. If the Bulgarian are able to achieve this general approach, and if they finish the governance, the energy efficiency regulation, and the recast of the renewable directive, they will have had a marvelous presidency on the domain of energy, and I'm pretty sure that the minister and her team will make all the efforts necessary to achieve that result.
Благодаря ви, господин комисар. Сега ще дам думата за въпроси. Моля всеки, който задава въпрос, да се представя с името и медията, която представлява. Кой ще бъде първи? Българска национална телевизия.
Светелина Катанска от Българска национална телевизия. Министър Петкова, споменахте, че България се поставила за цел да постигне общ подход. След като днес чухте мненията на различните министри от различните страни от Европейския съюз, каква е вероятността наистина да има общ подход? И един въпрос, свързан с енергетиката в България. Знаем, че 50% почти от енергията се произвежда от въглищни централи. Именно срещу това, така да се каже, се обявява Европейския съюз. Искат да се намалят вредните емисии. Какви стъпки може да предприеме България в този случай? И въпрос към еврокомисар Канете. Какво ще се случи именно в тези държави, чиято голяма част от енергията се произвежда именно от подобни централи? Благодаря ви.
Благодаря. Що се отнася до възможността да бъде постигнат общ подход, след като чухме каква е визията на държавите членки, след като чухме каква е тяхната гледна точка по отношение на регламента, свързан с сътрудничеството между регулаторите на енергия в рамките на Европейския съюз, аз смятам, че и съм обнадеждена, че ще има такава възможност да бъде постигнат общ подход. Българското председателство ще работи за това да бъде постигнат такъв общ подход с оглед следващи преговори с Европейския парламент. Работим изключително целенасочено, работим изключително отдадено по отношение на това да постигнем наистина максимален напредък по всяко едно от тези досиета. В работата си разчитаме на партньорството и на Европейската комисия, на нашите партньори, на колегите, на останалите държави членки. Така че смятам, че твърде вероятно и вероятността да бъде постигнат такъв общ подход е наистина голяма. Що се отнася до въпроса, който касае националната ни политика в областта на енергетиката, това наистина е една много сериозна тема за българската електроенергетика. Вие всички знаете, че малко повече от 40% от електрическата енергия в България се произвежда именно от въглищни централи. Разбира се, България като страна членка на Европейския съюз споделя изцяло и подкрепя изцяло визията на Европейския съюз за преход към нисковъглеродна икономика, за декарбонизация на икономиката. И ние работим и ще продължим да работим в тази посока. Знаете, че България е една от държавите членки, която първа успя да постигне своята национална цел по отношение размера на дела от възобновяеми енергийни източници в крайното си бруто потребление на електрическа енергия. Тази цел ние трябваше да постигнем до края на 2020 година. Всички знаем, че тази цел ние постигнахме още през 2014 година. И това е 16% дял в крайното брутно потребление. Що се отнася до въглишните централи, вие знаете, че директивата и този документ, който Европейската комисия прие през април месец 2017 година, залагайки много по-високи изисквания към този тип производители на електрическа енергия, предвижда и възможност държавите членки да кандидатстват за определена дерогация. Така че това, което България ще направи, темата, по която ние работим с цел на първо място да гарантираме енергийната си сигурност, е свързана именно с това централите, в които работят на въглища, да кандидатстват за дерогация, разбира се, ако те отговарят и ако спазят всички ясно посочени в директивата изисквания. Благодаря ви.
Yes, to say that the Commission always respects the right of member state with full sovereignty to decide their energy mix. It is written in Article 194 of the Treaty, and each member state can decide how they produce energy. At the same time, member states have to comply with reduction of emissions, and each member state has binding targets. In the case of Bulgaria, attending special circumstances and therefore sharing resolution, it has a zero target, so because we have acknowledged the difficulties of a country like Bulgaria. But in the case of renewables, we are discussing at the moment in energy efficiency, European targets, and there will be national climate and action plans in which each country will have some elements of of renewables, some level of renewables and some levels of energy efficiency that we will have to discuss with the Bulgarian government. There will be an European target, there will be countries in Europe that will have more ambitious targets than the European target, others that will have reduced targets, so we will have to discuss what that. But what we have to take into mind is that the cost of renewables is getting down so low that renewables are very competitive. In the auctions that have taken place in the European Union, they don't need support, they don't need the state aid, they don't need, they are competitive, and they will become very competitive. And the Bulgarian economy will require cheap energy, and renewables in the future are going to produce sustainable energy, but energy much more competitive than fossil fuels in the future. So we have to assure an energy transition, and that's why the Commission is going to develop a mid-century decarbonization strategy, in which we are going to analyze the economic and social impacts of this process of decarbonization. And for the coal regions in transition, we have created special platforms to analyze how we can assess the impacts in the different territories of the chain of the way we are going to produce energy and which actions we have to make in those territories to reindustrialize, to have new skills, new business opportunities, new growth, new jobs. So it is the process of achieving the targets under the Paris Agreement. It's a progressive process. We will present the Commission in November our decarbonization strategy for 2050, and we will assess all the economic and social impacts and consequences. The only rule that we have in the packet that we are currently discussing in the market, in electricity market design, is that for coal power generation, there cannot be a state aid subsidies if you emit more than 550 CO2 grams per kilowatt hour. This is under discussion. There is a position of the Parliament. There is another position, much more flexible, of the Council, and it will have to be decided probably under the Austrian presidency, which is the final scheme of available for this kind of plants. They can produce without state aid. Nobody can limit. But if there are big emissions, more than 550 grams, then state aid will be limited, according to the results of the trilogues between the Council and the Parliament.
Благодаря ви. Други въпроси? Госпожата до микрофона.
Кремена Кръстева от Дарик Радио. Моя въпрос е към комисар Канете. Каква е вашата позиция по отношение на идеята ВЕИ-производителите да излязат на свободния пазар, идея, която предстои да бъде заложена като промяна в закона за енергетиката в България?
Къде?
Бихте ли повторили?
Въпросът е, каква е вашата позиция относно идеята производителите на зелена енергия да излязат на свободния пазар? Това е идея, която предстои да бъде заложена като промяна в закона за енергетиката и се обсъжда от народните представители в България.
What I can answer you is that what the Commission wants is that the provisions for electric markets of the third energy package are fully implemented in all the countries, in the countries belonging to the European Union, and also that the countries on the energy community progressively align their acquis to those rules. And then in the future, when we approve the clean energy for all European packages, all the 27 countries of the European Union will have to apply the new provisions. And the new provisions which establish is the access are made to facilitate the access to renewables to the market and to facilitate that consumers produce their own energy and then they sell to the markets. But we are currently discussing these new regulations, how distributed generation will be engineered, how we will integrate renewable energy in the market, not only in Bulgaria, in the 27 member states. And once we have the regulation, we will know which changes have to be introduced, not only the Bulgarian regulation, but in all member states, in order to implement the package that we are going to approve.
Благодаря ви. Вестник сега. Момент. Вестник сега. Вие сте след това.
Добър ден. Моят въпрос е към комисар Каниете. Аз се казвам Светослав Терзиев от Вестник сега. Господин Каниете, моят въпрос е свързан с една наказателна процедура на Европейската комисия, която е приключила и от която чакаме окончателни резултати. Става дума за процедурата за свободен достъп до газопреносните мрежи. Това е процедура срещу България. По нея вече имаше позиция на комисията и позиция на българския парламент, който се произнесе, че няма да признае вина на България. Кога комисията ще обяви своя отговор, своето решение и защо го бави? Благодаря ви.
We are responsible the European Commission to implement the third energy package in all the member states. And every month we launch infringements to different member states. Each item has a different timetable. We currently, we prefer to discuss with the member states, have a dialogue with them, have to be able to see we can pass the legislation in the national parliaments to fully implement our package, and when it's impossible, we refer items to the Court of Justice. But I don't remember by heart the numbers, but this is a substantial number, the one of the infringements we are currently taking to the court, and every month we have cycles with 50, 60 who affect all the countries. So this is a normal procedure because in the end it's the Court of Justice of the European Union who decides who has done the things right. The Commission may have a view, the Bulgarian government may have another, and then the Court of Justice will decide which is the right interpretation of this ruling. I cannot give you a precise date, but my team is here and can facilitate you supplementary information about this specific hypothetical infringement, what is the situation and how it's, when we will go or what will we do.
Благодаря. Politico.
Hi, it's Anka from Politico. The question is both to the minister and to the commissioner. I'm wondering if you can give us a better sense of how discussions went today and whether or not you felt there's a willingness on behalf of countries to actually boost the targets further. You mentioned there was an exchange of views and so on, but if we can be a bit more concrete on where countries stand and if we can name some countries, that would be great. And Commissioner, even though this is a legislative process and the council has to find an agreement with the parliament, did you also have a wider message for countries in light of meeting the Paris Agreement goals? I know the Commission is preparing a decarbonization strategy looking more forward for 2050, but I wonder whether beyond the legislative process there's a wider picture that countries should keep in mind. Thank you.
One of the messages I was sending the minister today is that when I sit with the environment minister, they are asking me to raise to the level of ambition of reduction of emissions of the European Union, that we go to the United Nations and present a more ambitious national determined contribution than the reduction of 40% that we already have. And I say, well, your environment colleagues are asking me to increase the level of ambition, but when it comes to the ambition in renewables and energy efficiency, which are the tools needed, amongst others, to raise emission, some of you are very conservative. So I would like the same level of ambition across the different departments of the government. That being said, we have had all kinds of interventions today. It's pretty clear that there are some member states who say that they can go over the 27% in renewables, and you have all kinds of figures. From some countries who want the same figure of the parliament of 35, and from countries who want to stay with the 27. So it will be, there is a sense of movement towards higher figures than 27, that's clear. Eh? But not so close at the 35 that the parliament has. So it's going to be difficult. But the target is what we will decide at the last minute, at 3 a.m. of the last trilogue. It's always that the case, no? It's complicated, and the Bulgarian president will have to fight for being improving the mandate they have to negotiate in this issue. And in energy efficiency, we are in the same situation. But the problem, but probably for me, the most important thing is to have a strong governance. Because whatever is the target we agree, it's a European target. And afterwards, we have to have in the national climate and action plans targets for member states that they have to achieve. So we have to have mechanisms to fill the ambition gap, to make sure that adding all the contributions of the different member states, we reach the European target, first of all, and then the delivery gap, that once we have agreed how the efforts have to be made by member states, that they deliver on that, and that we are on track. No? So the governance regulation, on the governance regulation, there has been much more, coincidence in the positions for having a strong governance. And I think that the governance chapter is one that the presidency may accelerate the work, because there everybody agrees. Even in Asia, also we have made progress. On the targets, we have all kinds of views. If you can see what Germany says something, France is a little bit different, the Baltic countries have a position, Sweden, Denmark, Luxembourg and others are another. You have all the possibilities at the moment. But it will be a tough discussion. It's very clear. But what I have told them today is a very clear message. When we made the calculations for having a 27% target, there was a cost of renewables. Today, solar panels have fallen by nearly 80%. Offshore wind and onshore wind also have fallen down. The cost of batteries has fallen down. We are in a different scenario. And when we made the 27% per study, when we established it, it was the percentage who was achievable on a cost-efficient way. Today, with the cost of today, 30% is achievable with the same cost as 27. And IRENA, the International Renewables Organization, says that 34% will be available in 2030 on a cost-efficient way. So I told the member states, from a cost-efficient way, we can be more ambitious. And energy efficiency is a win-win policy also, because there you improve energy security, you create growth and jobs at local level, and for sure you improve the quality of air for your citizens. It's very clear that this is a policy in which it's worth going forward. That was a policy, a target that I went further than the European Council. The European Council had agreed at 27, now we are on 30. At least the 30% is not discussed by nobody, and there are some who want to go further. But the Bulgarian presidency will have a very tough job raising the level of ambition, and the Commission, as an honest broker, will try and help that the final product is at the level of ambition needed to fulfill our commitments under the Paris Agreement.
Благодаря ви. И за последен въпрос.
БНР, програма Хоризонт, Юлиана Корназева. Господин Канете, въпросът ми към вас е по-скоро уточняващ. Когато колегата от БНТ ви попита за въглищните централи, отговорът, който вие дадохте, беше за възобновяемите енергийни източници. Моля ви сега да отговорите за бъдещето на въглищните централи и дали това беше пък вашия елегантен начин да ни кажете, че те трябва да бъдат затворени. Благодаря.
No, what I'm saying is that we are in the process of decarbonizing our economies in the future. It's a long, it's a process. And that renewables will have a more important role than fossil fuels in the future. That's absolutely clear. But we are now today in 2018. We are not in 2050. And that's why we have created the platform of coal regions in transition to analyze what will happen to these plants. With the actual legislation and with the future legislation, coal generation plants can continue working. What we say is they will not be able to get, for the new, if you build a new plant, you will not be able to get a state aid to finance it. If the market pays the price, okay. But what happens is in the market, renewables are more competitive. What I'm telling you today here and in every country is the trend of reducing the cost of renewable is such that in a few years, they will be more competitive than coal plants. And then each country has decided, do I want cheap energy for my citizens? Do I want my industry to be competitive? And then they will have to opt for the, the sources of energy within their territory who produce the cheaper energy. That's what the minister tries to do. We need secure energy, we need clean energy, and we need cheap energy. But all the process will be on a smooth trajectory, and we have to analyze the economic and social impact in areas which are very clear that economy dependent from coal mines and coal power generation. But my message was the Bulgarian government has the right to have the energy mix. They can have nuclear, they can have hydropower, they can have coal, whatever they like. And the Commission doesn't interfere in that. We only say to Bulgaria, you have to reduce emissions here by this percentage. And you have to also incorporate renewables in your economy. We will discuss with a formula which is the reasonable level of renewables you may have in the future. And you should increase the energy efficiency of buildings because they were built, as most of the European Union, in times in which the technologies used were not those of insulation, and from the point of view of 80% of the European buildings are inefficient from the point of view of managing energy. So it's also policy we would recommend. But they can produce whatever they like. Take it into account what is the evolution of cost of energy in the future, and take it into account that at some stage in the European life, in 20, 30, 40, 50 years, we'll fully decarbonize. Because in order to obtain the agreement, the targets of the Paris Agreement of well below 2 degrees and 1.5, we have to fully decarbonize our economies. And that's pretty clear. Not today, not tomorrow. So this is a process. It's not that I was speaking renewables, not to try not to answer the question.
Благодаря ви, господин комисар. Доколкото виждам, няма други въпроси, които ми позволява да благодаря на министър. Един последен въпрос. Заповядайте. Може ли на микрофона?
Нищо не казахте за атомната енергия, за атомните централи. Те могат ли чрез тях да се намали микса
На въглишните в микса въглишните централи частта.
Nuclear energy is not one of the options member states have. Under Article 194, they can have an energy mix, and we have all kinds of examples. See countries like France, with a weight of nuclear power enormous. Others have taken the decision to stop nuclear energy, Germany, completely. But we are at the moment, there are new nuclear plants being built in different countries of Europe. The Commission, what only says is that we, if a member state goes for nuclear, we must assure the highest levels of safety and security for the citizens. And that's the responsibility of the Commission. And also that we have geological depositories for managing waste fuel that the member state have to comply with the directives to manage wasteful nuclear fuel. So it's an option that the member states have. There are no emissions of CO2, but what we also try, if a member state goes, wants to use nuclear power, we also, from the point of view of security of supply, we also look at who is going to supply the fuel, and is going to be a full dependency of nuclear fuel from a country, how we can make sure there can be other suppliers so that nobody depends on a single supplier. The policy of the Commission, whatever energy we are talking about, is that each country has to have different supplies and energy, or about nuclear fuel, also the same story.
Благодаря. Мисля, че с това вече можем да приключим нашата пресконференция. Благодаря на министър Петкова и на комисар Канете и на всички вас за многото интересни въпроси и до нови срещи.
Благодаря.
Thank you.